Yes, Cass. So we briefly sort of talked about the World Cup qualifier that began for England against San Marino on Thursday night as England came through to win that one 5-0, an expected win. And we talked about whether or not, you know, England should be playing nations like San Marino. And we're both in very much agreement that yes, they should be, because it's all about for the good of the game and the far reaching good of the game as well. But yes, 5-0 was the scoreline. Four different scorers, in particular Calvert-Lewin getting two goals and Ollie Watkins as well on his debut. Notice I mentioned Ollie Watkins? but it kind of, we were talking about this before we came on air and as we were having our build-up to our conversation about what we're going to be talking about over the next couple of days on our show. And you wanted to talk about the England striking options and what Gareth Southgate has available to him. First of all, obviously, Harry Kane, we know. He's captain. He's going to be one of the first picks for Gareth Southgate. But right now, the choices that Gareth Southgate has for his striking options, it's not bad, is it?
It's not bad. And what one thing I would say is that I always feel that you need pressure on the number nine shirt, because England have had some great goal scorers over the years, and Harry Kane is certainly that now. But you want players coming in, even against weaker opposition, whether it's Danny Ings, whether it's Ollie Watkins, whether it's Calvert-Lewin, come in, they score. Now, that's not going to put pressure on at the moment, but if you know that they're going to continually chip in and do well at their clubs, I found international football is different from club football. You can go quite long periods at club football and not score. Now, Harry Kane's gone quite a long time without scoring for England, you know, if you think, but he's still number one. OK, well, that is quite rare in itself that he can go a number of internationals and not score. I personally feel that when you get to a tournament, if strikers go out of form, you can be left out after a couple of games. So England will get to tournaments. They'll get to the Euros, or they got to the Euros. They'll make a World Cup. When you get there, it's a lot different because you can't have strikers go out of form. Now, if Harry went two or three games in the group stages and England qualified but he struggled, he could easily be out of the team. You want players to be able to come in and, you know, with a lot of enthusiasm, a lot of belief and trust in them that they can do the job. England haven't had that enough for me. They've relied, you know, Wayne Rooney went for a long period of being the number nine for England, even when he's formed. And I think he's only got one goal in tournament play, hasn't he? Match finals, you know, which is never enough. Wayne done an amazing amount of things for England. Goal records, appearances, you know, the age he played. He had a great tournament in Portugal. But if you look at his record over tournaments in general, it wasn't very good. You know, as in getting goals.
I mean, he did have a few injuries going into tournaments.
Of course, and
then
when injured. By the way, England have done this way too often, taken too many players to tournaments who have been injured as well. That's another issue. Well, I mean, I go back. I was at the World Cup 82 in Spain. Trevor Brooking and Kevin Keegan were there. They came on in a game. And they were both injured. And you could see they weren't fit. That's happened on several occasions with England players. Whether it's been Rooney, whether it's been Beckham, you know, they've had players that have been injured who have gone to tournaments. And, you know, there's no guarantee. I was at World Cup 90. I was our top goal scorer in the qualifying campaign. After two games, I was dropped. Well, that's, you know, that happens. Noel Quinn came in and done brilliantly well.
Why were you dropped?
I didn't play well. Right. Well, Jack told me, I won't use his actual words, but he said you were not very good. and I got dropped. And I remember sitting on the bench in the quarterfinal of the World Cup, and I looked across and I saw Gianluca Vialli on the bench. Now, he was the main man before the tournament started for Italy, didn't score, had a couple of indifferent games, and Scolacci came into the team. Now, that is not out of, you know, the realms of possibility that Harry Kane might find himself in that scenario. Go to a tournament, don't play very well, then suddenly steps in. Now, I do feel there's a group coming behind, or two or three players coming behind, that are very capable now of stepping in if Harry's not fit.
You mentioned he's not scored for England for a while. You've got to go back to the 17th of November 2019.
That seems, I mean, I know, seems incredible, doesn't it?
Yeah, that was against Kosovo. Now, I mean, there's three games coming up for England, having started with that game against San Marino. But when you are playing, and I hate saying the, I keep saying the likes of San Marino, but I am using it in this term. Do you think there'll be any frustration from Harry Kane? And it is a case for Gareth Southgate, damned if you do, damned if you don't, that he might not have thought, if you'd played me, I might have scored one or two, maybe got.
Well,
he'd have
definitely got. He'd have definitely probably equaled what Calvert-Lewin got. Yeah, so we'll be disappointed that he didn't have the opportunity to carry on trying to get closer to that record of Wayne Rooney. You know, that will be one of his goals, most definitely.